Welcome to IGM Guru. IGM Guru is one of the global leading online training and certification provider for IT expert by the skilled IT gurus to help them achieve their professional goals.
Let's start with the part for SAP S4 HANA. Okay, so I'll go with the basics. Okay, means in the chronological order. Okay, how and why this came? Why SAP came up with an altogether new product? Okay. And then slowly we'll go in the system, and then because I'm just trying to connect it, it is getting some issue. Okay, so I'll connect the system in some time, okay, and then I'll show you the remaining part in SAP. So let me start with the chronological order. Okay, so basically, as we know, this SAP it's a German firm, okay, and established in 1972. It started its journey with R1. So what we know is SAP R3, right? This SAP R3 means what? This R3 means three tire. Okay, so three tire means the one which you see on the system, that is nothing but presentation layer, after that the application layer, and then the database. Okay, database, this is application layer. Okay, so this kind of this is the system which we see, but initially they started with one tire only, then they came up with two tire, finally they came up with this new architecture, three tire, and it was quite stable since 1991. Okay, so that time the product was completely stabilized, and they rolled out it in a lot of EHP upgrades then. Okay, this was the SAP R3. R3 means we used to call it sometimes like SAP R3 4.7. Okay, what is this 4.7? This is nothing but this is the older version. After this what came? So 4.7 is the older one. Okay, after 4.7 in 2004 around, another stable product came up, SAP ECC 6.0. Okay, SAP ECC 6.0. Now this 6.0 has lot of EHP upgrades. EHP. So they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ... Okay. Now this was the actual journey which SAP was doing. This was the very much stable product, and this was known as Enterprise Central Component. Okay, 6.0 or 6.0. Now EHP1, that means Enhancement Pack 1. Okay, one second. Okay, so these were the EHP upgrades. Okay, so EHP upgrades means what? So these were enhancement packs. What is an enhancement pack? So for example, let me take one example, EHP 7 and EHP 8. Okay, in between I will draw a line and I will take a scenario like down payment. Okay, so if you remember or if you have seen, in my row screen, you get the option of down payment, and there is a new functionality over there where we can process the down payment against the invoices there itself. And this is the case when we are coming through MM path, the logistic path for finance invoices. Okay. So, and this was not available on this side. This came up with enhanced functionality on the right hand side. Okay. So earlier we were having T codes to process, but after EHP 7, okay, SAP came up with a new tab on the MyRow, okay, and they started processing it. Okay, this was like EHP scenarios. Okay, so whenever SAP has some new thing, okay, they simply release one EHP, okay, and it comes up with some new functionalities. So clients were asking, okay, now we are going for EHP upgrade, EHP upgrade. You would have heard a lot of times EHP upgrades. Okay. Now, after this, what happened? Already, there were a lot of other competitors. SAP has a lot of competitors in the market. Okay. It's an ERP market. So other competitors already started innovation. Now, why SAP did not start an innovation themselves? Back in 2003, 2004, something came up like CRM. It is not our tool for finance, okay? But the competitors started emerging with new innovations, okay? So something like CRM came, okay? Then Salesforce, so many things comes up, okay? SAP did not start their journey of innovation there itself. What they tried to do, and what they tried to do is basically they try to improve their market, okay? Now, what is the current architecture? So there is one presentation layer that is nothing but your desktop screen or my laptop screen, any screen, okay, where we log in the SAP. So it is nothing but SAP log on screen. Okay. Then we have application, and then we have database. Now the thing is this database, okay, this was not SAP's. This was non-SAP, okay? SAP was not providing this database, okay? So what they said, since they were having only the software component, this hardware was provided by some other vendors. So it could be Oracle, okay? Big Data, okay? A lot of vendors were there, okay, who were providing this database. Now the problem was when SAP asked these people to increase the efficiency, okay, to increase the efficiency of the database, okay, so that they can maximize the usage of the overall functionality. Then what happened? These people were quite okay, but the thing was they were very slow, okay. So what SAP said, let us do some R&D and we will launch a substitute for this, okay. So that is what they called as HANA, okay. Now when this HANA came up, it does not come up for a finance or any other part, okay. The journey for HANA itself is also very different. Now initially when SAP launched HANA, okay, then let me draw one screen, one diagram, okay, presentation, application and database. Let us say this is ECC, okay. So what SAP said? SAP said, okay boss, we came up with new product, okay, you please use it. But the thing is, all the clients are very big clients, okay, all Fortune 500 maximum of those are using SAP, and they don't want to take any risk with the database, okay. See, tomorrow if I comes up and I say, okay boss, I will give training for Fury is not my core subject, okay. So if I say that, even then people will not trust. Why? Because I don't have exposure of Fury, okay, and tomorrow just due to some reason I start giving it, that does not mean I will deliver some quality. Same thing was there with SAP. So when SAP came up with HANA, people were not ready to take it. The companies were denying it, okay. So what they said, okay boss, you don't replace, okay, let this, if you have Oracle database, okay, you keep it like this, not a problem at all, okay. And as we know, this whole system is known as OLTP. So our ECC system is nothing but online transaction. Okay, this T is transactional processing. And if you know the landscape, then there is one more thing. What is that? That is BW. That is BW. So what is BW? BW has one interface, okay, and they have their different servers, okay. So back in 2010, 2009, they had their different servers. Even now they have, okay, but there is a change. So they have their different servers, okay. So they were using some server. So what SAP said, okay, boss, if you don't want to use this, our HANA database in place of Oracle, not a problem. You do one thing. Since this is your reporting system, reporting means what? This was their OLAP. OLAP. A means analytical. It's for reporting purpose. Okay. Now, what they said, SAP said, I will not ask you to disturb the main database. But you do one thing, you take it as a test, okay, and you take this HANA database in place of BW server, okay. Now the companies were okay and they started mirroring. Mirroring means they started changing their BW as it is because it was SAP product. Now this was non-SAP and they first time came up with HANA. So HANA initially when it came as a solution for BW, okay, and this was known as, that time it was not like S4 HANA, it was known as BW Accelerator, okay. Similarly, there was one accelerator for financial solution also, that was COPA Accelerator, okay. So this was the solution for finance, but overall the first solution that came was for BW, okay. So what, it was just an accelerator. Why accelerator? Because what SAP was claiming and what SAP is claiming today also. So SAP is claiming even today, why they called it accelerator? It increase speed and speed and efficiency. Okay. So people started using it, okay, as a test because this will not impact their main business, okay. So they started using it and they were surprised with the results, okay. So they were surprised with the results. What were the results? The speed itself came 1800 times. So speed came 1800 times. There are a lot of things, okay. The speed, the performance, the tables, okay. Now HANA has a lot of technical things like the table change from row to column base, okay. Now what does row and column base means? That if time permit I will explain, but as of now I will go with the financial parts, okay. So a lot of results came up, okay, and SAP was happy, okay. Since SAP was happy, what they said, okay, now let us move further. What we will do, we will remove this HANA, okay. This HANA is there, not a problem. And here we have presentation layer, application layer, okay. Now what they were planning, something which was very critical, okay. What they said, to companies, since the speed efficiency is very good, why don't you do the financial reporting, okay. Why don't you do the financial reporting on HANA? So remember the terminology, it was financial reporting on HANA. Okay. So client said, what do you mean by this? How can it be done? So what SAP said, boss, what you need to do, you take our HANA DB. Okay. Now this BW story is over. Okay. This is done. So this was how SAP came up with HANA. Now they were motivated and they were moving toward further, okay, they are moving further. So what SAP said, you take the database as HANA, okay, and you keep this this application layer means it has all the modules, programs, algorithms, everything, okay. So they said you keep this on the top of HANA. Only financial parts, okay? Initially, only financial parts. Okay? So when this kind of thing came up, it was known as let me write here, SAP Business Suite. Okay, so back in 2012, late 2012 it came up, okay. In 2013 it came up fully, and this was known as SAP Business Suite or SAP Simple Finance. Okay, Simple Finance. The initial version which came was 1503. Okay, and after 1503 what came up? It came 1511. Okay, fine. So only the financial solution came, okay, on the top of HANA, because the reporting was very slow for the finance. So SAP came up with finance on the top of HANA. They said you use the database HANA only for finance reporting, and it started giving very good results. So results were good. Okay, the speed was very good, results were good. Now then what SAP said, okay, let me tell you one more thing. The initial name was not Simple Finance. The initial name what SAP suggested was Smart Finance. Smart Finance. Okay, then a lot of consultants and companies said, if this is smart finance, then what is a dumb finance? So this then SAP changed the name, okay, from Smart Finance to Simple Finance. Okay, and so this, now we came to 2013. Okay, so in the late 2013 when SAP came up with 1511 for Simple Finance, okay, so this was known as add-on. Okay, so Simple Finance add-on 1.0, 2.0, 3.0, these were the versions came, okay, different versions, but this was only for finance. Okay, HANA only on finance. So this was known as Simple Finance. So does this mean there was something like simple logistic? No, there was never a concept of simple logistic. Okay, since the results were very, very good, what SAP said, let us move not only finance, but all the modules. All the modules means the whole ERP. Okay, the whole ERP system on the top of HANA. So you keep on looking, like the non-SAP components, they completely removed. Okay, so on the top of HANA, all the core, so they call it core. Okay, so core means all FICO, HD, MM, PP, everything. Okay, so back in 2014, SAP came up with this new concept of core 1.0, okay, on HANA. And this core is nothing but, this was, they call it digital core. Okay, and this core came up with HANA, and this combination, now here it is all modules, it is not one module. Okay, this solution which came up, they started calling it as S4 HANA. Sorry. Okay, now S4 HANA. Since this is digital core, what they say? They say it has one component as finance, CO, PP, like this, all the modules all around. Okay, so there is a digital core which is attached to all the modules. This is the new design. Okay, okay. So when this came, the S4 HANA journey started. Okay. And S4 HANA journey means, so S4 HANA, then there was versions for, in 2015. Okay, again 2015 was the year when they were playing with this system. Okay, the first stable version for S4 HANA came in 1709. Before this also in 1610 and other versions were there. Okay, 1610 and other. Okay, but they were not very stable, there were certain loopholes. Even in this 1503, SAP forget to keep the cost center under controlling. Okay, so by mistake they kept cost center under joint venture. So there were a lot of such hurry-burry thing which SAP did, which they corrected over time. And in 2016 also the same thing was evolving. In 2017, they launched a version 1709. Okay. Now what does this 1610 or 1709 means? 16 is the year and 10 is the month. Okay. So October 2016, 1709, 2017 and September. Okay. Like this, they came up with 1809, 1909. Okay. So 2018, 9th month. Similarly, 19, 9th month. Okay. Now, I'm talking about these things, but definitely you would have heard of some more versions, okay, or releases from SAP. What is that? Something like 1506. But I did not mention anything here, right? 1503, then I said 1511. Then what is this 1506? Why I did not mention 1506? Okay. So this I will tell you in some time. So if you have this question in mind, park it. Okay, I will come back to this. So don't worry, this thing will be covered. Okay. Now when this came up, okay, this is how the system architecture looks like. Okay. And whatever I talked till now, this was for on premise. Okay. On premise. On premise means the infra, the hardware, the database will be managed by the customer. Okay. Will be managed by the customer. So that means there were different options, the deployment options. Okay. So there were different deployment options. Okay. Now let us come to deployment. So basically broadly we can say on-premise and on cloud. Okay. Now on-premise, whatever I explained till here, okay, everything was on-premise. Okay. So basically customer responsibility to maintain the hardware. Okay. In case of on cloud, okay, this was like a subscription. Okay. Subscription for what? For example, when we want to see the Netflix, okay, or some Amazon videos, okay, something, then what we do? We take their subscription. Okay. We park the videos, we will watch later, we sometime download offline. Okay. So those options are there. Similarly, here also SAP gave option. Okay. They said, okay, boss, you are a small client. Okay. You cannot afford thousands, lakhs and crores of rupees. You cannot invest that much on premise. You do one thing. I am giving subscription, SAP subscription. Okay. Here it is SAP subscription. SAP service subscription. Okay. So this, they said you use it, you pay us on yearly rental basis. Okay. This is rental. Rental basis. Okay. And this was on cloud. On cloud means the system maintenance, the system upgrades, everything is the pure responsibility of SAP. Okay. So that is what it came up here. Okay. And this was on-premise. So on-premise customer responsibility, on cloud SAP responsibility from the maintenance point of view. Okay. Even that most of the configurations will be done by SAP only. So what is the role of consultant here? Okay, so the role of consultant here and here is not same. Okay, here you already know whatever you are doing in ECC, same thing you will get in S4 also. But here the role of consultant is very less. Okay, maximum of the configurations will be done by SAP. Okay, even when you log in the SAP cloud, then what will happen? You will not see anything like a GUI, the SPRO screen. Okay. Nothing will be there. Only few configs will be there, which are very, very limited as compared to what we have here. Okay. So here, maximum things are kept by SAP with themselves. Okay. And they are selling it as rental. Okay. Now, on cloud means they will release every quarter. Every quarter. So if you see on premise, okay, 16, 17, 18, 19, they are releasing everything 1 year. Okay, but here they will release every quarter. okay, every quarter. Okay, now let us okay, so like this, the journey started for SAP. Okay, these are the deployment options. There are a lot of many things. Let us go to the system. Okay, give me a second. I will just check the credentials. Okay, one second. If you have any doubt here, you can ask. Okay, meanwhile, let me check the details. I will answer the queries.
Selendra is for on cloud. SAP itself done most of the configuration, and they are selling on the quarterly basis. So it means a very less role for the consultant.
Yes, yes. So that is what I said, right? So the role and everything is very, very limited to SAP consultants. Okay.
So the most of the organization has been gone to the cloud, or still they are on premises?
No, they see, it depends. It depends from client to client. Okay. Now what happens? Here,
because
what will happen?
Yeah, this is the challenges for our job. That's why I'm asking.
Yeah, I know, means the kind of feeling you are getting as a consultant. Okay.
Yeah.
But rest assured that if you are a finance consultant, at least no problem for us. Okay. Once again, I'm just calling one person, okay, for some connection. I will mute myself. Yeah. Okay, so I can answer the questions. You can ask the questions. Parallelly, I'm trying to access the server. Okay. You can continue. So, Sonal, you are asking something?
Actually, Selen, we have the lots of questions here, but it's not, will not come in a one session. Okay.
No problem. See, you ask because we have time today. Today, we specially organized this session to answer all your questions almost. So that is not a problem. Whatever we can, whatever we can entertain today means that you ask, or else we'll have those sessions. Okay. Later on.
Yeah. And Selen, will you give the training for us for 1809, which version?
See, if I get 1909, I'll give the training for 1909. So the servers will be taken care by Manish and his team, the location. Okay. So can you see the screen?
Yeah, Selen.
Yes.
Selen, let me know. I have one question. If suppose any organization, because they have the ECC itself, previously they have the ECC itself and they have migrated to the SAP HANA, and BW already has been stopped because the SAP S4 HANA is the new functionality. So whatever existing in the ECC system, suppose any open items for the vendor open items or the vendors, so how they migrated in the S4 HANA? Is any interfaces or how?
No, no, there is a complete tool for migration. Okay. So the way, and first thing, it is not purely migration, SAP call it conversion.
Okay.
Okay. So if you are using SAP already, okay, and you are moving on to S4, so it is a conversion project. It is not migration. Okay.
Okay.
Yes, yes. So for conversion, SAP has given tools.
Okay.
Okay, they are standard tools. So even you will not use even the LSMW and others. So for that, SAP has given that rapid migration tool.
Okay.
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 Let me just log in the system. So this is 1909. Yeah.
Hey, Shailendra, one thing I want to know, you will teach us the difference between the Simple Finance and ECC 6.0, or you will teach us whole Simple Finance with configuration?
Okay, Saurav, so as I said, Simple Finance is no more there. Okay, so that you will not be needing. Even if you want to ask questions, you can ask. But the thing is, you will not find the systems with Simple Finance. Okay. So no one is using nowadays Simple Finance. I simply explained Simple Finance because it was in the current quarter. No other purpose. Okay. Yes, yes. Okay, so any further questions as of now, or I'll move ahead.
Not yet. No. From my side.
Okay, fine. So I'll go ahead. Okay, coming to the system. See, the performance has increased. Lot of theory things I taught. Okay, but how it has increased? Okay. So something new has been given for financial parts, okay. Similarly in other modules also, in logistics also. So in finance, what has been given new is the table, okay. One very good table, ADVOCA, okay. So AC, accounting, DOC, document, A, actuals, okay. So it is accounting documents for actual line items. Similarly, we have accounting documents for plan. Okay, too many more. Okay, let us talk about actuals. Now, in actuals, okay, here I cannot see, means we have to go one by one. Okay, let me open the structure for AC Docker. Okay, so these are the different fields, okay, what you can find over there. So, one second. Yes. Okay. So these are the different fields what you will find over there. Okay. Oh, why? Okay. So here, these are the general ledger details which you will find in BSEG also. Okay. So this is not new. What is new here is you will find, first thing, there are multiple currencies. So the in ECC we had three currencies. Okay. Two currencies for controlling, three currencies for finance. But in S4, we have total 10 currencies. Okay. So local currency, group currency, or the controlling area currency, plus 8 freely definable currencies. So let me just show you. Yeah, you see here, freely defined currency 1, 2, okay. Go down 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so 8 currencies are there. Fine. So these things are there. Company code. Okay. One more thing is there. If you remember, in ECC there was a constraint, like you can have maximum number of lines in an accounting document, like 999. Right. Here that is not the case. Here we have. Let me just open that item part. So basically the line item numbers here, okay, they are with 999, okay. So it has been maximized by SAP for ADVOCA, okay. So that thing means there are more than 400 here. You see the number of fields there, 485, okay. When SAP first time launched ADVOCA, it was 289. Okay, today it has almost been double for them. It is moving to double. Okay, so it is today 485, and with each version SAP is increasing the number of columns here. Okay, so this is 485 as on date. Now if you see here, technically if you understand some part of that, then you will see one thing, how they have joined different modules data together. So there are includes, okay. These includes you will find everywhere. Okay, let us go down. Once new include comes up, that means new module details started. Okay, so okay, now here new include came up. So here it will start the controlling part, segment, profit center, trading partner, okay, all those things again came. So something new, value field, COPA details started. Okay, go down, currencies, okay. 8 currencies, 8 plus 2 basically, okay. The currencies are there. Then GL details, okay. Lot of tables have been scrapped. Tables have been scrapped, okay. The structures are still there. So tables and structures, there are two different things, okay. So tables means they store the data, structures means they don't store the data, okay. They are simply like the patterns. So tables are still there, okay. but lot of tables have been converted to structures. So those things are also there. Those things you would have heard or you would have seen in systems also, like BSAS, BSIS. Okay, a lot of tables have been removed. They are obsolete now. They have been converted basically to the structure. They are like just templates. Okay, whenever you want data, you can get the data. Okay, so like, and it has COPA details. It has AP, AR, asset, material ledger details are also there in this Ekdoka. Okay. Now, when I say AP, AR, material ledger, all things are here, then do you need the reconciliation? No, you don't need. Okay. You don't need if you have account-based COPA. Now, why I'm saying account-based COPA? Because account-based COPA is kind of mandatory in S4 HANA. Okay. What about costing-based COPA? Costing-based COPA is still as it is. Okay. SAP has not touched costing based COPA. Okay. So it is still the same. Okay. And then go down. Oh, the screen hang. Okay. So meanwhile, also coming to the master data. Now in master data, what master data we created vendors, customers. Okay. So if any of you have the FSCM or treasury exposure, then you will remember one thing. There was something like business partners. Okay. So business partners were already there. Okay. If you worked in FSCM or treasury, then obviously you would have used the business partner thing. But if you did not work on treasury or FSCM components like in-house cash, okay, and other, then you don't know the business partner. But today, each and everything has been converted to business partner. For example, the master data point of view, FK01, okay, press enter. What message it is giving? Redirecting to transaction BP as transaction FK01 is obsolete, okay. So something has been obsolete. What is the obsolete? The creation of vendors via FK01. Okay, fine. What about customers? Same thing. Okay, same thing. So these things are there. Okay, from the master data point of view, in bank accounting, there is huge change. Okay, FI12. Okay. So again, SAP removed this part. Okay, they again came up with this part. So a lot of changes SAP is doing is still there. Okay, but for bank account maintenance and everything, SAP is pushing you to mandatorily use Fiori or NetWeaver. Okay, so no more bank accounting can be done with only GUI. Okay, that has to be done with the help of either Fiori or with the help of NetWeaver client. Okay, let me just open the Fiori part. So Fiori you can launch from here, or this is the T code /UI2/FLP. Okay, so if you write it here, then also you will get it there. Okay, /UI2/FLP. So the respective Fiori will be launched. Present the function, it is not working here. Okay, but if the basis consultant activated, it will work. Okay, let us double click here. So it will come like this. Okay, continue. Okay, it will expand actually. 1 second. Okay, fine. So it looks like this. Okay, these are known as tiles. Okay, these are tiles. And okay So these are tiles, okay, and you can means these are added by someone. So you can add these things in the same fashion. Here is the search button, okay. Move it. Oh, it is not moving. Fine. So here is the search button. Okay. So if you click here, okay, it will. No problem. Let me click here. Array, I'm not asking recording. 1 second, let me move this. Okay. Fine. So let me go to, this is your profile symbol. Okay. Just click here. Not responding. Actually, the system is slow, I think, today. Okay. So actually you can customize what tiles you need, what you don't need. Okay. See here, I don't have option to remove the things. Okay. So if I'm using or not using, I will see all the options. If I'm only for general ledger, I'm a end user for general ledger, still I can see all these things, which will give a heart attack to any consultant. Okay. So many things, but in theory, it is not like that. If I am only for general ledger, what I will do, I'll ask my Fury consultant to add the tiles only for general ledger, and we can simply work on those 6 tiles, for example. Okay, I need not to check all, means I don't want to see all the other tiles like for logistics, for production, everything. Okay, so those things can be done here, what you need, what you don't need, and tiles can be added by you. The thing is, it is a bit slow. Okay. If I expand, okay, so whatever you want, you, okay, it came here. Here you see there is a app finder. Okay, so for example, I cannot see here a settlement one. Means I don't see the settlement T codes are KO88, CO88. Okay, I don't see a tile for them. Okay, so what I can do, I can search the tile and I can add. Okay, so to search your tile, you click on this profile symbol. Okay, go to App Finder. One screen should come. Okay, so here we will get the whole catalog. This is known as catalog. Okay, the whole catalog will come here, and the type. Oh, failed to load. Don't know why it is not working. Okay, no problem. Here we'll get whole catalog. Okay, and from there we can okay, now you see what you want. Whatever you want, you simply search. Okay, go down. All modules are there. Okay, so let us say I want to see something in cash management. Okay, click here. Okay, manage workflow. Okay, let us say something came up. Okay, here you see the pin. Okay, click on this pin. Okay, now you want to add it where? Do you want to add it in the master data? Yes, I want to add it in the master data. Okay, then close. Manage workflow was added to the group master data. Okay, now let us see. Okay, user menu. So basically this app will back. So the app which we just pinned, okay, that pin symbol. So that will add that app onto my master data folder. Okay, so, okay. Now where is the folder? So all these things, my home, current settings, master data, these are the folders, okay, or the groups. So click on the master data training. Wait, it will come. Click on the master data. Okay, so here you will find, yeah, you see you simply add it so easily. Okay, you don't need your basis consultant or anyone. You can add it by yourself. I added this one, okay, in front of you. Okay, similarly, all these things can be changed. Okay, display SEPA or something, whatever. Okay, now coming back. So this is the table. Okay, there are a lot of tables. So this is for financial part. Similarly, there is table for material, mat doc. Okay, all the material documents table. Okay, for material ledger there is new table, ML doc. Okay, material ledgers new table. So a lot of new tables are there. A lot of new configs are also there. Okay, so configs are also there. Now, if I show you some part, means how, see, if you want, there was a question from Sonal about migration. So I said it is not migration, it is conversion. So in case of conversion, what configs you need to do? Okay, so everything is here. Okay, so it is known as conversion, and then everything is here. Pre-migration, post-migration, migration, what you need to do, okay? So all the configs, these new configurations are in place, okay? Then after that, multi-bank connector means all these are new configurations, okay? A lot of new configs are there. For assets, new config is there, okay? So whenever it will come, I will simply keep on telling you about those things, okay? Similarly, you have a cross application component. Basically CVI integration, what we call customer vendor integration, okay? So that comes under this cross component, okay? Master data synchronization, okay? CVI integration, okay? So here we synchronize the customer vendors, okay, together. So this whole config is there, okay? This was there, okay, earlier, but now it has came up with CVI. So some new nodes are there, okay? This was already there earlier. Now some new configs have been added by SAP, and it is mandatory to use business partner. Okay, fine. So I will stop the session for today. Okay, if you have any specific questions, then you can ask. Okay,
Shailendra, there are two questions from my side. Can you share the, will you able the, to share the SAP HANA configuration document, what will you cover in configuration?
So what I understood is, Saurabh, you are asking that whatever config I will do, will I share any documentation, right?
Yes, please.
Yes. All PDFs you will get.
And second thing, if I will go with this, class. So will you be able to take the class after office?
Means
approximately 9:30 or 10 o'clock in the evening.
That thing, I think you just check with Lokesh and you let me know. So that question you can pose it to Lokesh.
Okay, no issue.
Yeah. So any questions regarding the session today?
Yes, Shailendra, I have one question related to the, which I have seen the Fiori also. So there is a link between the SAP HANA system and the Fiori both. Is it mandatory to add that boxes you have added now related to the bank configuration?
Yes.
So that is the mandatory to add those tables or those buttons those boxes you have added in the Fiori, so those are mandatory?
Yes, Sonal, without that how you will work? So that is something like when I want to post a document, what I do, I go here, okay, then what I do, I go here, I click on this, right?
Yeah,
so
correct.
Those tiles are like these T codes. Okay. So if that tile is not there, you cannot do or postings, right?
So after that tiles we can able to see in the screen, correct? Am I correct? Have to add those tiles, and after then I have seen. Yeah, yes. Firstly I have added this here, then only I can see there.
Let us say I added this create asset. Let me click on this. It will take some time, I think, but the screen will come to create an asset. Okay, see the same screen, right? AS01.
Yeah.
Okay. So it is same. So no change. Okay.
So we cannot directly just for the, just we have the system, okay, like 1809 or 1909. So we cannot directly make the configuration in the ECC. We directly make the configuration. We go to the SPRO and we have started to the configuration, correct? So in the same way, we never do it in the S4 HANA.
No. So coming to the config part, I did not said, okay, that config will be done in Fiori. Okay. Yes. So config still means you will not do in Fiori. The things are still there in ECC. Oh, sorry. On this.
S4 HANA.
Yeah.
Okay.
Other than there are few configs which is SAP is starting to add on the Fiori part, but still it is not there. Maximum things are there on GUI only. Okay. GUI.
Okay, so if suppose we stuck in your classes, after your class we will make the self practices. Okay, if we stuck in any of the configuration, can you help us?
Yeah, I'll be doing in front of you the same thing. Okay? And if you are stuck, you can let me know in next session.
Okay, fine. And I think Selen, because I would like to take the my certification that I have already told. So the sessions and whatever documents you will share us, that will be enough to give the certification.
So then, as I informed you earlier also, that I have the certification guide, okay, which I got from SAP. Okay, so that guide itself I will give it to you. Okay. If you get any doubts over it, has the it is like a question bank. Okay, so that is SAP plus only. So that is like a question bank. If you get anything, any doubts there, you can come back. And one more thing, see, coming to certification. So SAP, the certification, if you have done the ECC certification, then you will get same kind of 60-70% questions.
Okay.
So the questions will not change which you have given in earlier certifications. Whatever SAP has given you, for that questions will come.
Okay, thank you, Selen. Actually, session is very nice. So we will check with Lokesh what is the timing as per us office timing also, and confirm to the Lokesh.
Yeah, sure, Sumil. So, Saurabh, anything from your side?
No, thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you for your time.
Take care.
Thanks for watching the video. For full course, please visit www.igmguru.com and enroll today.